even if you just came into a bunker somewhere and had five swings where you just practice where you catch the line, that would make a massive difference. That's productive practice. But coming into a bunker and going like this and praying, that's not really going to help. It's not going to make you any better. So tiny amounts of practice doing the right thing can help, which is good news for most people, because most people hate practicing. Okay, so where I catch the grout or where I catch the sand, mega important. So that's a good thing to practice. But obviously using the bounce of the club makes all the difference. If I use the leading edge, obviously I'm going to get those chunky divots. You tend to lose a bit of height. It's either going to go in there and I'm going to struggle. If I time it perfectly, I might get away with it. But this is the part of the club designed to do the work for you. Okay, so that most people just have an issue because they set up incorrectly to start with their hands in front through fear, a bit like chipping, you know, you set with your hands in front and trying to dig for it so you don't duff it. That's what's actually making you duff it in the first place. It's the way the club works. So this part is really key, just to understand that's what you use to play the shot. Okay, so I'm adding a touch of loft, I'm adjusting my setup around so that my hands still in a good position, and I'm keeping that loft on the club all the way through. And all, you can almost go the other extreme. You can almost feel for most people like you're adding more loft, because most people do want to come back to square. They want to get the club squared up again because they're a bit frightened of playing the shot. So we'll play another one. Just keeping the loft on the club